Hi, I'm Daphne Richards, and this is Augie. Our question this week was inspired by a situation in the demonstration garden at my office. The landscape of the Travis County office of the Texas A&M AgriLife Extension Service is a teaching garden, and it serves as a location for lots of different landscape experiments, some planned, some not. At a recent team meeting with the Master Gardener volunteers that maintain the shade section of the garden, they asked to plant artichokes. Knowing that artichokes are full sun plants, I was surprised by this request until I walked over to the proposed planting spot, which was on the periphery of the garden in full sun. But it was also 9 a.m., and what the Master Gardeners didn't know, since they only work in the garden for a few morning hours every other week, was that by around noon, that spot would be in full shade for the rest of the day. Taking advantage of this opportunity to illustrate a concept, I explained the situation, then we proceeded to plant artichokes in two spots. Several months later, there are clear differences in growth between the two plants. In more shade, the plant is darker and taller, while the one in more sun has less color and is shorter. Neither is as healthy or robust as they would be in full sun, where artichokes perform best. Plants grown in more shade, if they tend to need more sun, grow taller because they're stretching to find the light. Shade-grown plants also need more chlorophyll to perform photosynthesis and feed themselves in lower light levels, so they're darker green compared to the same species grown in more sun. So before you plant, be sure to analyze the entire path of the sun, making sure that the level of light is appropriate for the species. And don't forget, the path of the sun changes with the season, being higher in the sky during the summer and at a lower angle in the winter. And also be aware that some plants that are labeled full sun actually may benefit from a bit of afternoon shade. It's all very complicated and experimentation may be key, so don't be afraid to move a plant or replace it if it doesn't do well after a season, which is what we plan to do with our artichokes. Our plant this week is Soft Caress Mahonia, a lovely little evergreen shrub. Although it appears tropical, Soft Caress is listed as hardy to zone 7 and should have no trouble at all with even the harshest Central Texas winters. This delicate-looking plant has attractive wispy foliage and will form bright yellow flowers from fall through spring when temperatures are cool. According to the label, Soft Caress may be planted in part sun to shade, an example of that complicated labeling I just referred to. So here's my experience interpretation to help you decide where to plant. Morning sun would be great, but direct light in the afternoon should be avoided, and Soft Caress will do just fine in full shade, in other words, no direct light at all, as long as there's a fair amount of light filtering through the canopy above. Soft Caress stays relatively small, getting only 3 feet tall and about as wide at maturity, and doesn't need as much water as you might think. Water well until established, then cut back irrigation, except during the hottest, driest times. Our viewer pick this week comes from Jenny Ostertag of a beautiful queen butterfly on Greg's Mistflower. Greg's Mistflower is one of the best plants that you can put in your landscape to attract butterflies. We'd love to hear from you, so please visit us at klru.org/ctg to send us your questions and photos.